Friends, this is Sonic Toast, and today we're doing a NECA Turtle unboxing review extravaganza magic rabbit toaster hippopotamus. All right, got a lot of NECA Turtles that I've been meaning to open for literally months, literally. And so I just can't wait to get these guys open. We're going to open them all today in this one single video. So thank you so much for being here. We are going to open today the Genghis and Rasputin pack, two of the punk frogs. Unfortunately, I only have those two. And then we're also going to be opening the Bebop and Rocksteady pack. This is super exciting because these are ones I swear I've been looking for these guys, waiting 2 years probably for them. I mean, it took a really long time for me to finally get a hold of these guys. And then we got Ultimate Muck Man. Here we go. Muck Everlasting. This is really, really exciting. So we got him right there. That was probably Krang. And then we got the Mondo Gecko pack, Shred Mondo Shred. And this one, of course, comes with Kerma. So that's exciting too. So we'll take a look at all of these. And last and not least, Baxter Stockman from Turtles in Time, the ultimate Baxter Stockman. And this one is also super exciting. Big Apple, 3 a.m. So we're gonna get all these things open so I can finally put them away. And yeah, this is going to be amazing. Toast. So first things first, the punk frogs come with this really cool Florida swamp background. That's awesome. Here they are out of the box, two of the punk frogs. On the left we have Rasputin with his bow and arrow. On the right, my favorite, Genghis Frog with his axe. Rasputin, I couldn't believe they never made an action figure of him in the original Playmates figures, which was always a kicker because in the show he was like the only one who ever did anything. All the other frogs kind of just stood around. I guess Napoleon did some stuff with his whip sometimes, but it was mostly Rasputin shooting his arrows all the time. Yeah, nice shooting, Rasputin, is what the frogs say. All right, so of course the frogs are just repaints of each other. They are the same figure, just painted to look like the different characters, which is just fine because that's pretty much all the characters are. One thing to be careful with, Rasputin's quiver of arrows. The strap broke off as soon as I tried putting it over his head. As soon as I did that, it just broke. So I had to glue it, had to take his head off, put the quiver on, and put his head back on. That is how you're supposed to do it. So yeah, that was unfortunate. And overall, great articulation on these figures. You got double jointed knees and elbows, twisting wrists and everything, and a lot of cool accessories that come straight from the show. So here are the frogs' accessories. They each come with two extra sets of hands. One thing I find a little disappointing is that Rasputin comes with the peace sign hands and Genghis does not, which is a little disappointing because when Shredder introduced Genghis to Bebop and Rocksteady, Genghis was the one who holds up the peace sign. Instead, Genghis comes with pointing hands, left and a right, and he also comes with fists, left and right, whereas Rasputin does not have fists because he has an alternate set of open hands instead. Unfortunately, like with the turtles, it doesn't really matter who gets which hands because they're all the same color. But with the punk frogs, they are all different colors, so you can't mix and match the hands as easily. Now, the heads are kind of exactly the same, actually. So you get four heads total, and one smiling and one that looks scared, right? So Genghis, by default, came with a scared head, and you can switch it out for the smiling head. Rasputin started with a smiling head, and you can switch it out with the scared head. They each also come with themselves as a baby frog, which, well, I guess they're not technically babies. They're just little non-mutant frogs. And they each come with a turtle communicator, too, a turtle comm. And the last two accessories are unique to Genghis Frog, being one of the more popular ones. He did have, well, not his own episode, but an episode where he was away from the other frogs, where he came to the city wearing this disguise along with a suit and tie. So he comes with this awesome hat and mask disguise, which is really cool. And then down on his foot is the mutant trap that Dirk Savage set for mutants. And when Genghis and Napoleon arrived in New York, they came out of the swamp and Genghis stepped right in the trap and he got captured by Dirk Savage, meaning the turtles had to go save him and Napoleon. I loved season 7. All right, when we get to the end, we'll compare these guys to their old action figures. Now let's move on to Mondo Gecko. Shred Mondo Shred. And this one comes in this cool window box, has some really nice photography there, and it actually shows Mondo with Kerma on Kerma's ship flying through space, which is really funny considering those characters never interacted with each other throughout the entire run of the show. You can see there's even a picture of Kerma riding Mondo's skateboard, which also never happened. Whereas this bottom picture has Mondo with Mikey holding a gun, which is like straight out of Mondo's origin story episode. So that one's kind of cool. So first of all, we have a new background here, or it's kind of an interesting background because it is a flat photograph of the building playset that NECA makes. The one I can show you, mine, as it is right here on my shelf. And there's the spot right there that they have taken a photo of with the door and everything. So that is an interesting choice for a background. We got some cool references and Easter eggs here. First of all, it says Mr. X and Gecko. Mr. X was the villain, the human who took Mondo Gecko when he was being mutated in the ooze and raised him to be a criminal. We have an Ace Duck poster here. Ace Duck, we know, is a movie brand that the Turtles like to watch. Above him is a wanted poster for A.J. Howard. He's the politician who hired Dirk Savage to hunt the mutants, but it turned out he was a mutant himself. And on the right, we have a silhouette. Who is that? It looks like Zack the Neutrino to me. That's who I believe it is, and maybe that's a teaser that Zack is going to be an upcoming figure. We will see. I hope they do Kala. Alright, so first let's look at Kerma. So I'm super happy to finally have a Kerma action figure. Kerma is a reoccurring character. I think he was in 4 whole episodes, whereas most characters only appeared in 1, maybe 2 episodes, most of the supporting. Kerma is an alien from the planet of the Turtaloids. He is a Turtaloid, and he's from a dystopian city called Shell-A-Ra, where they make everything out of gold. Kerma, being such a prominent character throughout the series, I'm kind of surprised that this is all he is. He's just a figure with limited articulation, that he comes in a pack with Mondo Gecko, whom he never interacted with in the show. Kerma has no accessories. He does not come with his little gold-making machine. He does not come with, like, the sheet of gold or anything like that. Honestly, I kind of feel like Kerma should have come with someone else. There was Destructor X, who was like the Terminator-type robot that was hunting Kerma, the Turtles had to protect him from. That would have been a great pack, Destructor X with Kerma. There was Captain Dread, who was like the space pirate who attacked Shell-A-Ra in Kerma's final appearance, and that was the episode where Kerma learned how to fight, actually, so he could help defend his planet from Captain Dread and also Groundchuck and Dirtbag. Kerma also created his own robotic turtle guardians that were based on the Ninja Turtles. They could have made one of those come with Kerma. It's just very odd to me that he would come with Mondo Gecko. It kind of feels like a cop-out because Mondo Gecko is $40. That's $10 more than a normal Ultimate figure. And I almost feel like that's because of Kerma. It's the extra $10 because you get an extra character, Kerma, in there with him. I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Now here is Mondo Gecko himself, and he simply looks amazing. He has all the great articulation you would expect from these figures. His jaw goes up and down so you can make him talk. He has a removable tail, which is just fine. Goes on really easily, not like those Triceraton tails. And yeah, overall, this is just a fantastic looking figure. So of course he comes with his motorized skateboard, which honestly, if he didn't come with that, that would just be a crime against humanity, nature, the multiverse, everything. And of course the wheels do roll, so that's a nice little feature. So Gecko's default hands are the open hands. He comes with one extra set with the closed hands able to hold accessories. And he comes with a bunch of accessories that are all callbacks to his first episode. So he comes with a sack of money because Mr. X raised Mondo Gecko to be a criminal. And so he would steal sacks of money that look just like that. He has a gun because he held Michelangelo hostage through like that whole episode and was always holding him at gunpoint. On top of the gun there, you'll see the gecko. That is Mondo himself when he was a non-mutated animal, little baby gecko. That's one thing I kind of didn't like about that episode. They kind of changed the origin, saying that there was a gecko along with the four turtles when they were mutated. And Kermit, you just killed everybody because Kermit just dropped the bomb. This is the like nuclear bomb that Mr. X had Mondo steal from like the army. And he had Michelangelo held hostage as he had the bomb all ready to go. And my favorite part of that episode was when Donatello disarms the bomb. He cuts the purple cord because it matches his bandana. And then the last accessory is the bracelet, which gets stuck on a mutant when they get captured by Dirk Savage. In that episode in season 7, after Leonardo and Michelangelo get captured, Mondo Gecko volunteers to be bait, allowing himself to be captured by Dirk Savage so that Raphael and Donatello can follow him to go save Leo and Mikey and Genghis Frog and Napoleon Frog, their friends. It's funny how many callbacks we have to that one episode with these figures. We have the bracelet on Mondo Gecko, the foot trap on Genghis Frog, and then the sign of A.J. Howard in the background. That is three references to that one specific episode from season 7. And that makes me wonder, could they be making figures of A.J. Howard or Dirk Savage? I do wonder. That was also, that one episode was the only appearance of Toka and Razar in the entire animated series. So, you and me messed up. Of course, Toka and Razar should come in a two-pack. What if they, like, split them up? What if, like, Toka came with Dirk Savage and Razar came with A.J. Howard? That would be terrible. Please don't do that, NECA. I was wondering if Dirk Savage and A.J. Howard, if they came in a two-pack, if they would be popular enough to actually sell, you know? Who knows? All right, well, let's move on. Toast. Next up, we're doing the Ultimate Muckman Joe Eyeball figure, Muck Everlasting as it's called. And one thing I love about this is the callback to my favorite part of that episode when Joe Eyeball holds out a ball of slime to Irma. He goes, hey Irma, I want you to have this to remember me by. And Irma goes, what is it? And Joe Eyeball's just like, I don't know. That's like the one part in the whole episode that made me laugh out loud. I love that they do that little callback there. So first, Muckman comes with a very similar background to Mondo Gecko. Only difference here is that it doesn't have the graffiti on the door. It's scooched over a little bit more. We don't have the silhouette in the window. And then there's also the posters, wanted posters for Jersey Red and Mad Dog. And looks like Scrag is the one under Jersey Red. Of course, Scrag's in a figure soon, so that's exciting. And here they are, Joe Junkie and Garson Grunge, better known as Joe Eyeball and Muckman. And Muckman is humongous. I love the proportions here. One thing I'm not crazy about is how Joe Eyeball does not stand on his own very well. He has too much weight on the front. He has no articulation. Maybe he does have some articulation. Yeah, his arms move. He's got ball joint arms here. But that's about it. Of course, Joe Eyeball is meant to ride in the garbage can that goes on Muckman's back. And the trash can just hooks right onto his back perfectly. Alright, so the sculpt looks amazing on these guys. They look exactly like they did in the cartoon show, and that is just fantastic. One thing about Muckman, he was a very confusing character for me as a kid. I swear on the back of the packages, Muckman was listed as a bad guy. You know how they have the good guys at the top of the package in the yellow and the bad guys at the bottom in the blue? I swear he was in the blue section at first. So I always believed he was a bad guy. When I played with my old action figures, I'd always use him as a bad guy. Then when he was in the show, he started as a bad guy because Shredder, tricked him into working for him and fighting the turtles, as what always happens, which happened with Mondo Gecko, which happened with the Punk Frogs and many other characters. They start as a bad guy and then eventually realize the turtles are the good ones and they become good guys. I was so confused that Muckman became a good guy. After that, I started noticing him in the good guy section of the packages all the time. Not only was he in the good guy section, there was also the other character, Mutagen Man. And I swear sometimes they were misprinted, where on the back of the package, Muckman was listed as Mutagen Man. These are just my vague memories from when I was like 8 years old. I could be remembering wrong, but I swear Muckman was just a really confusing character to me as a kid. As for his other accessories, he comes with two alternate hands, a left and a right. He comes with an alternate mouth, and he comes with a gun. I don't remember him ever using a gun in the show. The original action figure did come with like a cannon though. And the best accessory is this canister of goo. Well, it's more like a barrel of goo, which is made by Trobatron Labs Compound X7. This is the special mutagen that Shredder came looking for at Trobatron Labs. And when he couldn't find it, he told Bebop and Rocksteady to trash the place, and they dumped it out the window. And he goes, "No, you fools, that's what we were looking for!" And of course, it falls down onto Joe Junkie and Garson Grunge, transforming them into Muckman and Joe Eyeball. Now I have a huge regret, as I just took the plastic wrapping off to look at the goo inside the Trobatron X7. And sure enough, the label came off with the plastic. Oh, I wish I didn't do that. I wish I left it on, because that's the coolest part, because that's a reference to the specific episode. There, I was able to peel most of the sticker off the plastic and put it on the container itself. I can't wait for this winter when my Irma figure comes in the mail. I can reenact my favorite scene where he goes, "Irma, I want you to have this to remember me by." She says, "Well, what is it?" I don't know. Just a handful of goo. Oh boy. You know, I used to think that Muckman and Joe Eyeball were supposed to sound like Fred Flintstone and Barney Rubble. It's not until I was older I realized they're supposed to sound like the characters from The Honeymooners. Of course, the Flintstones also were based on The Honeymooners, so that's kind of funny. And then with the alternate mouth, you could, you know, probably make him talk, reenact that scene from Robot Chicken. Muckman, one of the only turtle characters to get his own Robot Chicken sketch, where, about the, you know, that was probably Krang. Krang, man. Is there a full banana peel melting into my head? So funny. Anyway, so there's that. Here's another little piece of trivia for my channel. One of my earliest videos, called The Hedgehog Without a Job, in the musical number, the original Muckman figure can be seen dancing around with the other characters. Now we'll take a little break from the cartoon to get to the video game Turtles in Time, Baxter Stockman from Big Apple, 3 a.m. So Baxter's background is the first level of the game, Big Apple 3 a.m., and we have Krang in the background there, so that is a cool background. I wish it were a little bigger, though. That's my only thing. I wish it was more encompassing. But besides that, it's still cool. It's kind of nifty they decided to put Krang in there, too. Here he is, and he looks amazing. He looks fantastic. His mouth opens and closes. He has bending, twisting wrists, double jointed elbows and knees, ball joint arms and legs, bending ankles. I mean, he's got all the articulation you would expect from a NECA figure. And here he is next to the cartoon Baxter Stockman, so you can see the difference. I'm so glad they gave him a unique sculpt for Turtles in Time and didn't just repaint him like they did for like Leatherhead and Shredder. He looks amazing. So great. Now, when it comes to accessories, he by default has the open hands. He's got closed hands, fists. And he's got the gripping hands, of course, for holding his accessories. His weapons are pretty perfect. First, he has like his machine gun from the beginning of the battle. And then he comes with his crazy, like, handgun thing also. From halfway through the battle, he changes weapons. And you can see the gun has this big, huge hand that comes out of it, just like in the game. This thing is huge. I think this is why it had to be like an Ultimate Deluxe figure, is for this thing. And then he comes with two clear plastic stands. One is meant to hold Baxter himself, to suspend him in the air, making it look like he's flying. So that is pretty fantastic right there for sure. And the second stand is to have a little support for the big gigantic hand coming out of his gun. So you can set him up and pose him and stuff. So that's pretty nifty right there. All right, well, this has been a lot of fun so far. We just have one more set to unbox. And you know, it's funny how every character we've unboxed so far has been green in one way or another. We're just gonna have to fix that with this. Rocksteady and Bebop.
Yes.
These figures come with the original cardboard sewer background that all the early figures came with. All right, these are the ones that I've been looking forward to the most. I honestly think these are the figures that made me start collecting NECA Ninja Turtles as a whole. Because when this cartoon series first came out, they were like Comic-Con exclusive, and I thought, yeah, those look nice, but I don't think I could ever get them. Then they started releasing them. They're really hard to get. And then when these guys came out, I was like, oh my gosh, I gotta start collecting these. And for 2 years, I've been looking for these. Oh man, I tell ya, these figures, like, I was looking for them for so long. Going to Target after Target after Target, could never find Bebop and Rocksteady. And then, NECA put them on their website in like, last August. They put them up on the website. So I ordered them off the NECA site, and then I go to Target, and there they are. They had Bebop and Rocksteady at my local Target, like literally maybe a week or maybe 2 weeks after I pre-ordered them from NECA. So I bought them at Target, and I'm like, well, mine are coming in the mail, so there's no need for two. So I call my uncle who collects figures. He can listen to his podcast, Where the Toys Are, because he's really into action figures. Say, hey, do you need Bebop and Rocksteady for your collection? He's like, yeah, I totally need them. So yeah, you know, I hand them off to my uncle. He pays me back for them. And I just waited and waited and waited. And Bebop and Rocksteady finally came in the mail weeks ago, actually. A couple weeks ago, these guys came in the mail. And I've been so busy with all the new Mario and Sonic figures from Jack Specific that I haven't had time to open Bebop and Rocksteady until now. I'm so happy to have them open. They look amazing. They have fantastic articulation. Even their jaws go up and down so their mouths can open and close. These guys look fantastic. They are nice and solid, and I am just so happy to have them in my collection. Now I just need to find April O'Neil, and I've got all the main characters. Toast. Boy, I love Bebop and Rocksteady. These guys aren't just icons of the Ninja Turtle franchise. They are icons of the stereotype of big, strong, dumb, goofy henchmen, duo henchmen of bad guys. Like honestly, when you think of a duo of henchmen, you think of Bebop and Rocksteady, right? They kind of set the bar as to what they could be, and their popularity is just outstanding. When it comes to accessories, they came with a single communicator with a picture of the Shredder figure on it. They each came with a set of guns, identical set of guns. Those are the generic foot soldier guns, and in later seasons meaning like seasons like 2 and 3, those are the guns that Bebop and Rocksteady used. And they each came with sets of alternate hands, the open hands and the gripping hands for holding their accessories. And their hands do look identical, actually. That's funny that Bebop and Rocksteady used the exact same hands, just painted different colors. So like I said, Bebop and Rocksteady did use these guns in a lot of episodes of the later episodes. They used the generic foot soldier gun. I remember hearing though that people were not satisfied with them coming with these guns because their iconic first battle with the Ninja Turtles in season 1, they used very specific weapons which seemed more similar to the kinds of weapons that the action figures of the time came with. Well, NECA thought of everything. So these guns probably look more iconic. Sure enough, NECA had both sets of Triceraton action figures come with these guns. So you should have an extra set if you collect these. If you bought both Triceratons, you should have an extra set of these to go to Bebop and Rocksteady. So I just want to show off these characters next to the original figures from the late 80s and early 90s. This was my first Rocksteady figure. Oh, I can still remember. I think my very first Ninja Turtle was Donatello. Then I got Raphael. Then I got Splinter, and my fourth figure was Genghis Frog. I took him to my brother's friend's house, and my brother's friend wanted to trade Genghis Frog for Rocksteady. And so I did. I traded my Genghis Frog for this Rocksteady figure that I still have today. Speaking of Genghis Frog, here he is, the original. And after I traded my Genghis Frog away for Rocksteady, my friend in first grade, my seventh birthday, my friend got me a new Genghis Frog for my birthday. So that was really nice. Same birthday that I got Toka and Razar and Super Shredder for my birthday. It was a good birthday. You know what's funny about my original Genghis Frog is that he made his rounds, because after I traded him to that boy, he traded him to another boy who then traded him to a girl. And I remember seeing her at a party and she had it. I knew it was my Genghis because I could just recognize the figure. Had the same kind of blemishes, same paint missing where mine was. And mine, the hand was broken off. The hand was broken off on that one. So yeah, totally knew it was the same frog. Anyway, it got around. Who knows where that Genghis is today. But this is the one I got for my 7th birthday and I haven't let go of it since. Toast. Here is the original Mondo Gecko figure, definitely a classic, and I have a t-shirt of that t-shirt with the skull that he's wearing. Where is it? Toasters. Oh, Bebop, Bebop, Bebop. I went through so many Bebops as a kid. I think this one was my 3rd Bebop. The first one I had the squishy head, and what happened to that one? The head, like, I took the head off and couldn't get it back on. My uncle gave me his Bebop eventually, and that one... I took off the legs. I took off a leg, and then I replaced it with a leg from a Dick Tracy figure. It was blue. Which Dick Tracy character was it that had blue legs? I don't remember which one. Anyway, and that Bebop eventually his hands broke off too. Then finally, I got an action figure of Forge from X-Men, and my brother's friend, same friend, had a Bebop action figure, and he offered to trade it. No, he traded it to my brother for something, and then my brother traded it to me for Forge. So there we go. That's how I got this Bebop, and this one I actually took care of. All right, Kerma and Rasputin did not have figures of in the original set. Rasputin got a figure for the 2012 series, but I never got that one. I never actually saw it in stores. I just know it exists from online and stuff, but I wish I did get that one. Oh, Baxter Stockman. He is such a tragic character, such a pathetic character in like every show. If he weren't just so gosh darn lovable, you know, he's just great. And there's the original Baxter figure. That was one, he was like one of my brother's favorite characters. So my brother bought Baxter, and eventually, since I was the one who stayed with the Turtles my whole life, it just kind of ended up in my collection somehow. Muckman and Joe Eyeball. Boy, I really, really love the original Muckman figure. I mean, that was one of my favorites as a kid. I think I was probably 6 or 7 when I got Muckman, and I just thought he was so cool. I loved him as a bad guy, I loved him as a good guy, and Joe Eyeball was so weird looking. He has a third eyeball down here somewhere, so that's really funny. So yeah, I'm really happy with the new Muckman. I'm super tempted to get the Super 7 Muckman because he's just such a fun character. He really is. Here they are all together, the old and the new. I love these new NECA figures. I love how cartoon accurate they are, and they are so much fun. All right, so now we will conclude, friends. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know in the comments section, what is your dearest memory of Ninja Turtle action figures, or even action figures in general, because they mean a lot to me and I want to hear what they mean to you. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, be sure to ring the bell for notifications and have a fantastic day. Toast!